So I hear that the angry video game nerd is working on a new movie, huh? That's pretty cool. And that there's some shit going around, that he's creating a fundraiser to raise money that he doesn't even need. That's kind of stupid. I guess that with the economy we're living in, some people just need the money, don't they? Yeah, I'm a very curious person. I always have questions stuck in my head that always desire answers. Like, now that the Iraq war is coming to an end, will the economy get any better? Or how is it that a whole bunch of internet celebrities are getting heat? And yet this talentless hack is getting away unscathed! Man, I'm pissed! Oh sure, there's plenty of other bastards out there in cyberspace to complain about, I'll get to them later. But I cannot ignore the fact that not only is this talentless YouTube whore polluting our internets, but our TV screens as well. Does anybody care? No? Yes? Maybe? Well, you do realize that this guy is making more money than half of the YouTube partners out there because he's constantly pushing out movies, music videos, albums, and now he has a TV show coming out on Nickelodeon? Are you serious, bro? Fred Figglehorn is the definition of sellout. His first big movie was the biggest piece of shit I ever saw. Chock full of lame, immature gags, including racist jokes.
Oh my damn, I dug all the way to China!
And a final climax that looks like it was edited with Windows Movie Maker. How very professional. Oh, and speaking of professional, congratulations, John Cena. Not only have you become the biggest ass-kisser in pro wrestling, but now you've completely sold out by starring in this abomination.
Hey guys, it's me, John Cena!
But wait! The fun doesn't stop there! Apparently, since audiences loved this movie so much, they had to make a sequel. Released just over a year after the first film in October of 2011, along comes Fred 2, Night of the Living Fred. Now, as a college student currently studying film, I always believed that any good film is made by good filmmakers. In this case, this particular film is directed by John Fortenberry, the same dude responsible for such classics as A Night at the Roxbury and Jury Duty starring Pauly Shore. And sitting alongside him at the producer's table is Lucas Cruikshank himself, teamed up with Mr. Brian Robbins, the director of the oh-so-timeless Shaggy Dog, Norbit, and frickin' Meet Dave.
Oh, yes! With a resume like that, this is sure to be a smash, huh? Yeah, smash, all right. Let's just get this started. This is Fred 2, Night of the Living Fred. Roll the footage.
Hey, it's Fred! My life is a horror movie! It's so scary! I'm so scared!
And you'll be too once you hear about it. You'll be scared and scarred!
Scared!
That's a new word I just made up. Scared and scarred combined, which is what you'll be.
20 seconds in and I'm already scared. Alright, first things first. For the three Pixie Lott fans out there, sorry to break it to you, but she's not in this movie. So when we see Fred and Judy in this totally lame Casablanca parody...
Here's looking at you, kid. Well, we'll always have the party where you threw up on me, Fred, now won't we?
You couldn't even get an actress to replace her? How freaking cheap are these guys? What, is the entire cast just gonna be Fred playing all the characters? That's a strong possibility.
Oh, but here's something you might find shocking. This movie actually has a plot. Yeah. See, Fred's favorite music teacher, Mrs. Felsen, has disappeared and is now replaced by this dude.
Who are you?
Well, who are you?
I'm Fred.
That tells me almost nothing.
I'm a student here.
I knew that. I was just kidding.
It didn't seem like you were kidding.
Or did it? I'm Mr. Devlin, the music teacher, and I want to help you join the world with music.
We already tried to get him to rule the world, and we failed miserably. How do you even think he's gonna fare in the world of music? He can't even make a good Christmas album.
So Fred is on his way home from school, where he spots some girl following him.
No, be quiet, it's okay. Don't scream.
Okay.
No comment.
Fred then discovers that Devlin is moving next door to his house.
By gammon, he's moving in next door!
Who?
Mr. Devlin, the weird... Hey, it's Fred! My life is a horror movie! It's so scary! I'm so scared! Now do you see why I was so scared?
Oh, that's explainable, Fred. You suffer from femalophobia type 1, a fear of little girls.
This is just ridiculous. These kinds of jokes could have worked if Fred was maybe 12 or 13, but Lucas is 17 in this movie. Seeing a grown man scared off by a little girl running around screaming in public is something a mentally handicapped person would do. Then again, this is Fred. So now we see Fred walking with Bertha, now played by Daniela Monet. And not only does she look absolutely nothing like Jeanette McCurdy, but her acting is even worse.
Why are you so scared? He's just a teacher.
He's responsible for the disappearance of Mrs. Felsen, Bertha.
Oh. I think Mrs. Felsen got fired.
Yeah, I guess that could have happened, except for the fact that it's impossible, because she's the best music teacher in the world. In the whole planet.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm in this movie, just playing some beatnik chick. Don't give a shit. So Devlin is creating a musical community called Join the World of Music, and Kevin is one of his biggest pupils. Yes, Kevin is back, and he's just as pathetic as a villain as he's ever been.
Ow.
Choose your weapon.
What's the purpose of these dream sequences anyway? They don't amount to anything. Again, it's just a piss-poor attempt to copy the flashback jokes in Family Guy. After school, Fred runs into the stalking girl from earlier, whose name is Talia.
I'm sure your piece was the best.
I know, right? I mean, to think that someone like Kevin is better than me? You have to be kidding me.
Yeah, he's terrible.
You're great.
Thank you. Well, we're here.
Hey,
do you like cookies?
I made you a cookie in chemistry class.
You make cookies in chemistry class?
It's 100% chemicals.
So it seems that Talia is Fred's new love interest. Anybody missing Pixie Lott?
What the H-E double hockey sticks is going on here? Is Talia imaginary? You saw her, right?
Oh, and here's another big problem I have with this movie. What is with all the jump cuts? I've seen sexy Phil videos that had better editing than this. Okay, so now we have Fred's mom, Hilda, appear, once again played by Siobhan Fallon Hogan. And then we have Kevin's mother, Janet, played by...
Hilda!
Flo from the Progressive commercials?
You are tearing me apart, Progressive Auto Insurance!
But wait a minute, we're missing one more character, aren't we? Can anybody guess who it is?
You're gonna go, that's what you're gonna do.
Dad!
You're gonna go, find out everything there is to know about this guy. He's a wrong dude, I can feel it.
I knew it, that's just what I was thinking!
This cottage cheese is also wrong. Throw it out.
Okay.
You get a full report and you get back to me.
Where will you be?
Right here.
Of course, living inside a refrigerator is a great way for Cena to cool off from all the heel heat. And he's not even a heel! So Fred and his mom go to a party at Kevin's house. Fred's mom and dad broke up a while ago, and now Hilda has her eyes set on Devlin.
So much talent to teach young kids. As a single person, I totally respect that. Hi, I'm Hilda Figglehorn.
Ah, hello, Ski. Jake Devlin.
Hello, Ski yourself. You know my son, Ferdinand, eh?
I don't know if I do.
Liar! You know me, you're my teacher.
I'm just kidding, Ferd.
Oh my gosh! That's too funny. You are too funny. Isn't he too funny, Fred?
Oh yeah, he's way too funny.
You must keep your wife in stitches.
Oh no, I'm not married.
What? A handsome man like yourself with the ability to impart musical knowledge? How do you keep the women away? Could I, get you a little drinker?
Just what this franchise was missing. Sensually flirting middle-agers.
Inside the house, Fred runs into Talia again, and finds out something very interesting.
Hey, Figglehorn! What are you doing talking to my sister?
I'm not talking to your sister, Kevin. I'm talking to Talia, who is your sister? What?
Oh my God, shut up out there, or I'm calling the internet police!
So Fred believes that Devlin's presence has put a hex on his life. He replaced his music teacher, his mom is bending over for him, Talia is Kevin's sister, and now he's trying to recruit everybody in the school to join his world of music.
What's his game? He keeps saying join the world, like it's a different world or something.
Right.
An alien world.
Oh.
He's an alien, Bertha. I know it. He's an alien sent from distant outer space to control our minds.
Well, you figured me out, Fred. I am an alien. The leader of an advanced team sent here to establish a beachhead in your friendly town.
Devlin!
Oh, I'm not Devlin. I'm...
Mansquito! You got anything to drink? Like all of your blood?
What the fuck was that shit? This is a kid's movie, right?
But maybe Devlin isn't an alien. Maybe he's something else.
Jeez, that's a little inappropriate, putting a vampire on a children's cereal box, don't you think? Wait a minute. That's it! The umbrella in the sunlight? The burying stuff in his backyard? Kevin's new haircut? Mr. Devlin is a vampire!
And speaking of Twilight Sparkle, we really couldn't have a cultural reference-filled comedic satire about vampires without a Twilight parody, right? Behold! Fred's head photoshopped to Taylor Lautner's body against a bunch of colon rejects.
We have my sister!
Surrender, Fred.
Okay, I'll surrender. Not!
Worst transformation sequence ever! Worst dog attack sequence ever!
Congratulations, Fred. You just managed to outsuck Vampire Suck. And believe me, if you can't even make a Twilight parody funny, you fail at comedy.
Later that night, when Devlin and Hilda go out on a date, Fred and Bertha follow them to a restaurant. Fred ends up becoming a cook, while Bertha is a waitress. As Fred cooks up a... sock, Bertha eavesdrops on the two lovers' conversation.
I mean, the kid sucks the life out of you. I mean, you know, you're with kids every day.
Have a side of fries.
Actually, they make me feel young. I guess I sucked the life out of those kids. I guess I sucked the life out of those kids.
So as Hilda continues to oogle over Mr. Vampito, Fred continues to spy on him, only to fall right out of his window. But not to worry, Daddy John Cena is there to help him defeat Devlin and Kevin. How? By having a match for the WWE Tag Team Championship, of course. No, I'm not making this up. As if the WWE couldn't sink any lower. Then Devlin and Kevin come out. And of course, since they're supposed to be vampires, they appropriately come out to the Brood theme.
You know, if Edge was still wrestling, Gangrel not directing porn, and Christian not acting like a crybaby, they'd come out and spear those little sissy vampires through the fucking hearts.
Oh my god, this match is a joke. I've seen jobbers matches that were better than this. And apparently this is a tornado tag team match since nobody goes to their corners and the refs don't even seem to care. And you really gotta love how there's no commentary. The last thing we need is Michael Cole yapping the entire time.
Fred and Michael Cole in the same movie? Hate!
In the words of Vince McMahon, expect the unexpected.
Ah, yes. You've certainly taught your son well, Cena. Now he's one of the biggest ass-kissers on YouTube. Hell, he's as good at kissing YouTube's ass as Shane Dawson was. Not sure he's as good as Ray William Johnson. He's a pretty big ass-kisser. Always has been, and still is.
The next day, Fred learns that Devlin has invited everybody to a recital being held at the school later that night. Fred believes they're all getting brainwashed into becoming vampires. Oh, come on! We barely went 5 minutes without a Cena appearance. Doesn't the 10-time WWE champion have something better to do? Like beat up Kane or eat a bowl of Fruity Pebbles?
You gotta suck his blood! Suck his blood before he sucks yours! Grab his head like this! Turn his neck sideways like this!
Fred getting his ass flattened. Why can't that happen all the time?
So Fred gets to work collecting stuff to use against Devlin. He gets a cross, or an intersection sign in this case, and... oh no, don't tell me. We're gonna have more jokes making fun of Asian ethnics, aren't we?
You have, like, chicken with garlic sauce?
Yes.
Okay, I'll have chicken with garlic sauce.
Okay.
Just hold the chicken.
Why you need garlic sauce?
Stop the vampire!
What the vampire?
Oh, it's like, you know, like a...
You? Vampire?
No, I'm not a vampire, but
what
you know
the vampire?
Yep. I called it. This movie wants us to believe that Asian people are stupid. Did I mention this movie came out right after the Japanese earthquakes?
Okay, it's recital time. Let's see how this train wreck goes.
Everybody have fun tonight. Everybody
that foul beast! These people will not be your minions! That man is pure evil!
Fred, don't be ridiculous! My gosh, I look like crap!
Remember, kids movie!
Garlic sauce! Damn it!
Hooray! The movie's over! Oh, damn it. It was just another dream sequence. The real scene has Fred randomly shooting people with garlic sauce out his water gun to protect them from Devlin. Seems logical, but wouldn't it make more sense if he just shot Devlin instead? The next day, Fred ends up becoming the laughingstock of the school. Devlin tries to make it up to Fred by inviting him over to his house. Fred is now entering the belly of the beast. Armed with an iPhone, that I would assume he got from my Justine, Fred conducts a live video feed of the inside of Devlin's house. Kevin catches the live stream along with his friend Diesel.
There's a letter in your mailbox!
Yeah,
Diesel.
You gotta watch Figglehorn's website right now, man.
I'm watching it. It's creeping me out.
Wait a minute. Black dude named Diesel with Train's poster on his bathroom wall. George Carlin sound clip.
There's a letter in your mailbox!
Is this movie trying to fuck with me?
Where am I?
I hope that's baloney.
No freaking way!
First film they tried to give us brain damage by having Fred constantly screaming, and now they're giving us brain damage with Fred constantly screaming, and then they're trying to get into our heads by throwing in cupcakes references?
No! I will not give in to your tricks, movie. I am going to finish watching you, or my name is not Hard Kamina Diane Kidd. And it's not.
So Devlin comes in and Fred ends up dropping the phone in a pot of boiling water, leaving the stream frozen on Devlin, who looks like he's dressed as a vampire. But as it turns out, Devlin only wore it because of his interest in Korean food, and he really isn't a vampire after all. And after a bit of more ethnic backstabbing, Fred and Devlin become friends. But Kevin and his posse have already watched the stream and think otherwise. The next day, the stream goes viral, and Devlin loses his job. Fred is unhappy.
Oh my gammon, I've got to take down my website before it does any more damage! Wowzer copter, is that how many hits are on my website? This is really bad. It's bad is what it is. This website is hurting people and hurt someone. But I could have like a really good life if I go through with this. I mean, like, the fans will keep building up, the views will rise. I'll give me and my mom the life we deserve.
Oh, knock it off with all the irony, Fred. Your reign as head YouTube whore died faster than the arrow in the knee meme.
So several random jump cuts later, Fred decides to come up with a plan to get Devlin's job back. Let me guess, he's gonna make another YouTube poop like last time? Well, surprisingly, no. Instead, Fred, Bertha, and Talia come up with this way of making Fred into a vampire.
Hey, Devlin! We're not leaving here until you let her go, man! Hey, Devlin! Come on, I know you got my sister in there!
He thinks Devlin's got Talia.
What? Well, I should go tell them where I am.
Wait, I've got a better idea.
We're gonna stare the shit out of them!
I'm not repeating myself.
And now the epic climax. I'm just gonna let this run for a bit.
Tonight, Talia is mine!
Figglehorn?
Just gotta put her down for a minute.
You've gotta stop him!
Me?
Yes, you! Here, take this tank and just drive it into Fred's heart!
Why do I have to do it? Why can't we get a grown-up to do it or something?
This is your sister, and it's because you and Talia have the same blood.
So why would that have to do with it?
You have to do it. You're the only one that can do it.
Come, my darling. Join me tonight in the undead.
You've got to do it. Stick the stake in him and drive the stake through his heart. Kill the vampire. Save your sister.
I'm vanquished.
Whoa. That was actually kind of cool. I never thought I'd say that in a Fred movie. Huh. And so the movie ends with Devlin telling Fred that he's moving away, and he and Hilda go out on a goodbye date. Everything is back to normal, John Cena is still living in Fred's fridge, and Devlin isn't a vampire. Or is he?
It's getting a little chill-ski.
Maybe it'll snow-ski.
Ah, you're so fun-ski.
Here, let me get the door.
This movie is better than the first Fred film, but it still sucks.
All the jokes fall flat, the editing is all over the place, and the writing makes as much sense as a Twilight fanfic. The love interest between Fred and Talia goes nowhere, the dream sequences are long and senseless, and the acting, while slightly improved, is still stiff and lifeless. This movie isn't as offensively bad as the first one, it just feels lame and unnecessary, and another piss-poor attempt for Fred to get back into the spotlight. But hey, I'd take it over Breaking Dawn any day.
So a hardcore headache for Fred 2, Night of the Living Fred. And Fred's status as the number one most smegged up YouTube failure is still going strong.
Speaking of which, from what I heard, last month, Ederim, the old pedophork I put at number one on my second list, actually died in jail last month. That's a shame. But I guess that means Mario Tet Plummer is now number one on the list, huh? Yeah, troll or not, that bastard deserves it.
What the fuck? Well, I got another big YouTube failure list coming up next month, so I better get that ready. 2012 is certainly shaping up to be one hell of a year, huh? Who knows what kind of horrors are lurking down the road? Attention grubbers with annoyingly high voices? Or communist feminazis with an Oedipus complex?
We're on our own, cousin, all alone, cousin. Let's think of a game to play. Now the grown-ups have all gone away. You won't be much fun being blind, deaf, and dumb, but I've no one to play with today. Do you know how to play hide and seek? To find me, it would take you a week. But tied to that chair, you won't go anywhere. There's a lot I can do to a freak. How would you feel if I turned?